3, 2, 1.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have beautiful Ina next to us. And Ina is a cosmetologist all the way from Connecticut. You've been here for quite a while. We both speak Russian as much as the folks behind the camera right now. And as you know, I go quite often on the screen. So makeup for the guys and the hairstyling is important to look good, so you kind of don't think that I'm sweaty and still look appropriate. As much as the gentleman who is holding the camera, controlling the camera at the moment behind the camera, is also quite I would say known producer at Brick, who won the award this year. So it's my great honor, and thank you, Ron, for filming with us. So we both, Roman and I, are guys. We're straight. We're not gay, but we, want to look good in front of the screen. So Ina is gonna share a few secrets as a professional makeup and hairstylist for gentlemen, how to look proper on the set.
Yeah.
Take it away.
First of all, you have to clean your face with tonic. Then you have to moisturize your face very well. Then you have to put a little bit primer on your face. And then you have to put a foundation. Foundation is
It's okay.
Foundation must
как сказать, должна подходить по тону кожи.
Has to be the proper color, the temperature, because some guys, like right now I'm kind of white after the winter season, but you see me next week after I come back from Florida, I'm going to be much darker, so you might need to have maybe lighter and darker colors of right?
Yeah, and then you have to put loose powder, because the skin have to be
not glossy,
yeah.
Okay.
For men, good
подчеркнуть брови.
To emphasize hair.
Eyebrows. To emphasize eyebrows.
Okay, we struggle a little bit with our English, but the information that you're getting here is priceless. Even though, like, we both have a little bit of an accent and a lack of vocabulary, it's still very useful advice. Guys, you can't imagine, like, how many times, like, today I'm supposed to have a much larger crew, and my filmmaking crew didn't show up, so what? I know how to lay cables, I know how to put up lights. Luckily, right now I have Roman helping me out. And you can see the difference in light that I was able to assemble on my own, and now that Roman is filming, it's quite different. I can actually look at the camera now and see you guys, and versus the first take that we just did on the other side, where basically I blast everybody with a ton of light and couldn't see ourselves. Okay, tell me a little bit about the journey. How to learn the hairstyling, the makeup look? Where did you get all your information? You had your salon back home in Ukraine, you had some business, but how did you start all that? Did you practice on your sister, on your mom?
Friends, my mom, my husband. I have experience more than 9 years.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm in USA almost 4 years. And okay. I work in a hair salon, like hairstylist and makeup artist.
Cool. One of the things that I started recently is a company, hopefully it will become very similar to Uber, but it's targeting the hair styling business, mm-hmm. and makeup and photography. I believe that most of the salon right now are open from 10 o'clock till 7 p.m., right?
Yes.
That's regular hours. In my business that I'm, we're just opening up, it has two more additional shifts. I have a shift from 7 p.m. till 3 a.m. and I have a shift from 3 a.m. till 10 a.m.
I'm crazy.
So when people need to have a makeup right in the middle of the night, they go in clubbing. They need to have a good look. They can come and get, some people work 9 to 7 and they can't come the hours when the hair salon is open. And they don't, if on the weekend they want to go outside of the city or they want to do something, they don't want to break their day just to go to get a haircut. Mm-hmm. So for the people who, let's say you wake up and you get a very, very important meeting in the morning and you know that you need to look cool and you need to have a haircut. You have the time, 5 o'clock in the morning, 6, like 4 o'clock in the morning before. So you can go in there and get your, New York is the place where, that's the city where that never sleeps. In this salon that we're opening, one in Brooklyn, one in the city in Midtown. We are not that far from here. We have the stage, professional backdrop, photographers, studio lights and everything. So the idea is that when are you looking the best? When you just in the salon, they did your hair, they did your makeup, and the wind didn't blow it, you still look awesome. So that's the moment when you can get your like the best look. So that's the photo studio that we want to build there. So people can get their LinkedIn professional picture taken right in the moment when it was like everything was perfect the way they like it. They see the mirror and and everything is staged. So that's, hopefully it will work out for us.
Yeah, it's true.
Tell me a little bit, and we want to make it a national, so it's will be same standard from any salon. So it's, you go to McDonald's, you know, you're going to get, you know, burger, french fries, and it will taste pretty much the same throughout the country. Same idea with this kind of level of proficiency in this particular salon. We want everybody to get proper training, proper quality of the makeup and hair, so it's kind of standardized rather than just you don't know what you're walking into.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because I think the Uber revolutionized the technology around the cars. So like we had so many pop and mom limo companies, car service companies, all that is gone. All the medallions have a hard time to survive thanks to Uber and Lyft and all those new technologies. So I think the next industry that will experience the major shift, because right now most of the salons are like owned by local folks. And when Walmart came in, when Amazon came in, they basically knocked off all the competition. It's just big monopoly. I don't know if I would be able to build monopoly on have just one hair salon for the whole country or whole world. But I think it's pretty a good target as the industry that not for been business. Changed for last 100 to 200 years. And all so many other industries have been changed recently.
Yeah.
And technology, exactly. I think, is the new gives the opportunity to change. Combining the night shift and combining photography and video and those services together, I think, might give a new edge for the for this kind of business. Because in the past, you had a phone, you had a calculator, you had a lighter, you had so many tools. Now you have one phone that does all the computer, all those tools, right?
Yeah.
So I think the barbershop should be also revolutionized and changed for the better, because those barbershops that have been here for 50, 30 years ago, they pretty much operating same way. They have not changed yet. So that's what we want to change. Tell us a little bit about your practice.
I'm study my professional in my country. I'm from Ukraine.
Uh-huh.
And I think that the best hairstylist in from Ukraine and from Russia.
Why? Because ladies pay attention so much for their looks.
Yeah, yeah. Very beautiful women and men also.
Okay.
So, and then I have I work in many places, and then I have my own salon. It was very good experience for me. And then I will come in USA, and I'll continue my practice. And now I work in hair salon in Brooklyn, in Zebra Hair Salon.
Okay. What's so special about Zebra Salon?
Very good hairstylist and nail service, also makeup and cosmetologist. Very nice people, and we have very good customers.
Is there a way to reach out to you for the audience if they want to hire you as the makeup and hairstylist?
Yes.
How can the email or something?
Instagram is Inna's Hairstyle. Also, I have Facebook, Inna Dolgodusheva, D-O-L-G-O-D-U-S-H-E-V-A.
Thank you.
Thank you.